Steps, order my steps, dear Lord. Amen. Solomon writes in the book, amen, of Proverbs, that the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Solomon, the steps in Abosha. I come to preach, amen. The Lord God has given me the green light. He says, prophet, I've taken the brakes off of you. Speak to your people. The Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth remain silent before him. Every head bowed, every eye closed. Eternal Father, gracious Lord, Master, healer, deliverer, friend. You said to your disciples, I no longer call you doulash, I call you friend. Doulash is slave. In Jesus' name. Now, Master, I plead the blood of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus on Satan. I plead the blood of Jesus on Jezebel. I plead the blood of Jesus on Beelzebub. I plead the blood of Jesus on all witches and warlocks. I plead the blood of Jesus on all sorcerers and root workers. And I bind them all and cast them all down back to hell from where they come from. And I command them to get out of my ministry and stay out in Jesus' name. Now, Father God, send your word. Lord God, send your word. Lord God, send your word. Master, send your anointing. Lord God, send your anointing. Lord God, send your anointing in Jesus' name. Father God, have your way in this place. Lord God, not my will be done, but let thine will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Now, Master, I thank you in advance for what you are about ready to say to your children in the name of Jesus. Now, Father God, anoint these lips of clay. Make the tongue like the pen of the ready writer. And I bless your holy name for it in the name of Jesus. Now, Master, I need you to come down. I need you to fill the sanctuary with smoke in Jesus' name. Now, Master God, have the angels to trouble the water, to make it easy for preaching in the name of Jesus. Now, Father God, I thank you. Lord God, I thank you. Lord God, order my footsteps in your word. And I bless your holy name for it in the name of Jesus. Father God, order my team's footsteps in your word. In the name, Lord, order my team's footsteps in your word. In the name of Jesus. Lord God, remember Kneecat Network, Page Studio. Lord God, don't order their footsteps in your word because they're not mobile. But order the people footsteps in your word. Send them to Page Studio, Kneecat Network. And I bless your holy name for it in the name of Jesus. Now, Father God, preach. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen, amen, and it is so. Order my steps in your word, dear Lord. Lead me, guide me every day. Send your anointing, Father, I pray. Order my steps in your word. Please order my steps in your words. I wanna be, hey! I don't need you right now, baby. I got work to do. In the name of my text is coming from the book of Romans. The apostle begins to help me come make my way home. I can't go home until I deliver this baby. I've been having labor pains. Oh, you don't hear me. Every preacher before he delivers the message that God gave him, he got labor pains. And the labor pains means something's coming. Ask the woman. Just ask the, hey, Bakata. Ask the lady. Hey, something happening. In Romans chapter 10, I'll pick up my text at verse 9. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and shall believe in thy heart that God raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. That's verse 9. Verse 10, for with the heart man believeth and right into righteousness, and with the mouth man confesses, confession is made into salvation. Do you know what that means? Wait a minute. I'm a teacher. Confession is made into salvation. Confession. You say, this is your statement. You confessing. Salvation is deliverance from the bondage of sin. Salvation was born on the cross. Before Jesus went to the cross, man didn't have salvation because we were hopeless. That's why he came. Amen. Verse 11. For the scripture says, whosoever believe on him should not be ashamed. Jesus says, if you deny me before man, I will deny you before my Father who is in heaven. He says, but if you confess me before man, I will confess you to my Father who is in heaven. Bible says you believe in him, you won't be ashamed. Amen. Somebody say amen. For there is no difference between the Jew and the Greek, for the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. Verse 13, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And verse 14, how then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? 15, and how shall they preach except they've been sent, as it is written? How beautiful are the feet of those who preach the gospel of peace and bring good tidings to the good news. Saints of God, my text today. Let me pick that up at 16, right? Right. Your enemy is tactical. Your enemy is tactical. Amen. You must understand that he ain't walking around with no pitchfork, no pointed tail, no horns on his head. He walking like man. Bible declares that he's an imitator. He imitates everything the Lord does until a certain extent. He's tactical. He knows that I told you in one message that the enemy is a profiler. He's studying you. Yes, he is. But he don't have to study long. He's got over 2,000 years of watching man walk this earth, leave this earth. But when he comes up against a full-fledged, blooded believer, he got to use tactics. He will come to you as a friend. The Bible says he ain't nothing but a wolf in sheep clothing. Oh, the enemy is tactical. He knows your desires. He knows your likes. In other words, when he's tactical, he's using temptation to lure you, to draw you, to catch you. He's setting traps. Bible speaks about the fowler. That's a trapper. He's a trapper. He set bear traps. He set traps. He set traps and come back and check the trap. He don't stay there. He's setting traps because he's tactical. Bible declares that if a man wants to be saved, we look at Romans chapter 10, verse 9 and 10. It says, if you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, you shall be saved. Because with the mouth, man confesses. With the heart, he believes. Hatabosha. That's what the Bible says. And he that believe on him shall never be ashamed. What is he saying? You won't be ashamed. Meaning you ain't going to do something that's going to make you look inadequate to who God says you are. It makes you look like something that would make you ashamed of yourself. I've done plenty of things. Many of things that I was ashamed of at that time. But now, baby, if I do it, I ain't gonna let it make me ashamed. You know why? That ain't what the scripture says. Because I sure believe on him. He said, if you believe on him, you won't be ashamed. Thank you, Jesus. Knowing that the enemy used tactics to lure man because a man's heart and his desires is not stayed straight on Jesus. Solomon writes at Abusha in the book of Proverbs that if you keep your mind stayed on him, he'll keep you in perfect peace. You must understand that we're serving a God that has declared and decreed that you have a fight, but that the fight is fixed, that you don't have to be concerned about the outcome at the end. What you got to do is keep on keeping on. You got to be like that little engine, that little train that was going up that hill. He would not let anything tell him anything about anything because he says, I think I can. I think I can. I think I can. I think I'm old shot. Who do you know in scripture that did that? The woman with the issue of blood. The Bible said when she was going to the prophet, she kept prophesying, if I could just touch the hem of his garment. If I could just, I can be made whole. You see, the little engine, the little train motivated himself. Like David says, you got to encourage yourself in the Lord. You don't need for the prophet to come down here and prophesy over your life and pray for you. I mean, the prophet will, but you got to learn how to speak for yourself. You got to take on the attitude of a Nicodemus. The Bible says he came to God by night. My bishop said God can help you with a nighttime problem. Now, you must understand that the enemy is tactical. He's always trying to put up things that would distract you. He will send distractions. Ask Peter. When Peter got out the boat, the Bible says that they were afraid. They thought Jesus was a ghost. They came in the fourth watch of the night. Fourth watch of the night. What time is that? It's the last watch. Huh? Just before day. The darkest of any night is just before daybreak. I should know. I used to be up doing cocaine. I didn't say I'm not ashamed to say what I just said. I got to tell you. But I'm getting up here and been preaching. And I ain't never did no dope. You crazy. I wouldn't be up here. I'd be somewhere in a little preaching to 10 people in a little church. That's crazy. I ain't ashamed. I know I hear them birds chirping. Now I got to take a shower and shave and go to work. I can't go to bed. And I'm not going to call people. What am I telling them? Wasn't nothing wrong with me yesterday. Oh, Lord, help me. Help. The enemy sent distractions. The Bible said, well, Peter told Jesus, if it's you, bid me to come to you. Jesus said, come. Peter got out the boat. Peter walked on water. And the enemy sent distractions. You say, how you know it's the enemy? Because he's the God of the atmosphere. He's the God of the first heaven. He controls the wind. He sent that wind, and the water got choppy. Bible said Peter looked, and he began to sink because he took his eyes off Jesus. That's scripture, baby. When you keep your eyes on him, you see, when you're watching him, the enemy can't use no tactics, huh? Did I tell you, the devil ain't no atheist. He is not, he's not confused or none of that about Jesus. Huh? Hallelujah to God. I look here in verse 16. In the same chapter, chapter 10, verse 16, it says, but they have not all obeyed the gospel. For Elijah says, Lord, who has believed our report? That's in the book of Isaiah chapter, help me, Holy Ghost, who have believed our, chapter 63 and 1. Lord, who has believed our report? Isaiah go after him. Mm-hmm. The prophet, Igwa. Mm-hmm. And 17. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Wait, wait, wait. How does faith, how do you get faith? You can't go to no university. You can't go to no junior college. You can't go to no technical school. Hmm? You can't be a Rhodes Scholar and go to Oxford. Hmm? To get faith. First, they said that you got to have a preacher. That's what he said. He said, hey, He said, how can they hear who have never heard? How can they hear without a preacher? But here's what's important. The Bible asked the question, how can a preacher preach except he's been sent by God? In other words, if he's a sent preacher, he's helping people. If he's a man, if he's sent himself, he ain't helping nobody. Nothing. Because he ain't going to go there. He don't know it. How are you going to do something he don't know? He ain't going to read the text to you. That's a false prophet. The Bible says he's already here. The Bible declares the Antichrist is the false prophet. He's already here. Okay, okay. Okay, in Jesus' name. So 17 says, so then, this is what it says. This is King James. It says, so then faith cometh by hearing and hearing by the word of God. What does 18 say? But I say, have they not heard? Yes, verily, their sounds went into all the earth and their words into the ends of the world. Hallelujah. We look here at that time, the apostle breaking them off something righteous. He declares that the bishop been preaching, but now I have read scripture to support my hypothesis. But it's not a hypothesis. A hypothesis is something that has not been proven. It has not been applied to anything. It's theory. It's still theory. This is not theory. Huh? Ha tabo sha. Huh? It says that faith come by hearing and hearing by the word of God. But it says, how can they hear without a preacher? Huh? You see, the enemy used tactics to change what I just read and spoke to you. If he can change up one word, ain't that what he did to Eve? He told Eve. He said, now, wait a minute. God didn't say you was going to surely die. He know the moment you eat from that tree, you're going to be like God. See, he switched it up. God told him, he said, don't touch it. Don't eat from it or nothing. Everything else is yours. Here come that serpent. The Bible calls him the old dragon. Here he come. Huh? The Bible teaches in Genesis 1 that God said, let's create man in our image. So Eve and Adam was already little gods, according to the scripture. But see, he turned it around. And soon as they ate that stuff, soon as that happened, that's when death came into the world. Man was created to live forever. This body will repair itself if you ain't got to put nothing on it. You might be itching and scratching, but that thing will close up and grow new skin on it. Praise the Lord, the bleeding will stop because God created this temple to last forever. But when man sinned against God in heaven, God had to come up and say, now I got to send my child. I've got to send a redeemer to redeem back my children. I got to take them out of the grips of the evil one because I come that they may have life and they're going to have it in abundance because the enemy used tactics. The enemy tells me it's all right for me to go on and you know what you used to do. I said, wait a minute. No, tell me what I used to do, punk. Tell me, punk. I've been born again. How am I? Ain't that a bullshit? Tell me, punk. Hallelujah. Hey, go ahead. Matter of fact, somebody will give you some. Go tell him you want to try some out, and then you're going to come back and buy. He's trying to get me back on dope. Yeah. You don't believe that? See, you don't know nothing really like you should know. God does not take the desires that you had. He just changes them and put them in different places. God didn't stop me from being an addict to have an addiction. He just changed my drug of choice. I'm addicted to his word. And I'm getting high right up. Right now, I'm over the limit. Right now. On the word of God. God, the enemy used tactics. I got the clothes, Lord have mercy. Boy, I am. I don't know. He worked me right into that one. He worked me. The TV, they call that a segue. He worked me right in. Isn't that what he did? I'm still high. I do it every day. It's got to be an addiction. I am strung out for Jesus. Write that down. Strung out. I don't know. Call it what you want. I got to have it. I got to have it. I don't think I'm going to close. I can't mess with it. He got me all messed up. Yeah, you got me messed up. I don't know where I'm at right now. Proverbs. Let me get in here. Boy, this man, he got me going. Proverbs what? Close. 16. Okay. All right. In Proverbs 16, am I close? And my text is, the enemy is tactical. The preparation of the heart in man and the answer of the tongue is from the Lord. All the ways of a man are clean in his own eyes, but the Lord weighs the spirit. Commit thy work into the Lord, and thy thoughts shall be established. The Lord has made all things for himself, yea, even the wicked for the day of evil. Hit the brakes. The Lord has made everything, even the wicked. Let me get it right. Even the wicked for the day of evil. He gonna kill you. Know what he's saying? He made you. Look at how many countries he destroyed. Them nations. Don't tell me he won't do it. God ain't got no problem killing what he made. Ask them people. You can't ask them. But ask the preacher Noah that built the ark. When God told him to build an ark, make it three floors. Put a door up in the top of it. The Bible said God closed the door. Am I close? I'm trying to close that up. In a day of evil, God created everything. Now, give me one more verse and I'm sitting down. Everyone that is proud in his heart is an abomination to the Lord. Thy hands join in hand and shall be established. Am I close? Verse 7. When a man's ways please the Lord, he makes even his enemies to be at peace with him. And close. Proverbs 16 and 18. Listen to this. I've been preaching this. Pride goes before destruction, and a haughty spirit before fall. I told you, pride goes just before the fall. You get prideful because of something that God gave you, and you take credit for it. God will snatch it away from you quicker than he gave it to you, because when God gives you a blessing, he gives it to you in increments so you can grow into the blessing. But when you get prideful, God snatches it all away. Somebody say it ain't here no more. Huh? Somebody say the enemy used tactics. It was a trick of the enemy to make you brag about something that God did in your life. God is able. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He will welcome me. He'll welcome me. Like a thief in the night. I'm living this life. Hey! And I'm on. Father, I love you. About the day that he'll come and fly away. Like a thief in the night. Yeah.